Google right now is a very, very large place. Prosperity for me is freedom of want and freedom from fear. The future of translation basically right now goes in a bunch of different directions. One of them is that we've consistently grown the number of languages we support. Another one is increasing the number or growing the number of modalities in which you can apply such technology. So for Translate specifically, this might mean that a conversation like the one we are having right now might in the somewhat near future happen in two or more than two different languages at the same time, and we might not even really notice because we have headphones in our ears that and microphones that pick up what the other person says in a different language and almost in real time translate it straight into our ears. So that's something that kind of, maybe you might want to call it the ubiquity of such technologies is definitely increasing. Google AI basically does a very broad range of things that at the highest level spans everything from fundamental research all the way to fairly applied research that is geared towards improving or creating specific products. And within those different tiers, you actually have a lot of mobility and also a lot of transfer of everything from ideas all the way to technology that starts out in fundamental research and then as it matures starts to be applied more and more in maybe an increasing number of products. So you'll find basically contributions to the academic community, papers and people whose output mostly consists of those, all the way to people whose contributions are largely focused around improving key metrics of products.